Hey, Kyle Sulerud here, and in this video, I'm going to take you into the Where Ads Showed section of your YouTube ads campaigns and tell you what to look for and what changes you can make to help improve your results. This is one part of a 14-part series where I'm helping you review and audit your YouTube ad campaigns. If you haven't downloaded my full audit guide yet, make sure to check the link in the description and get that right now. Go ahead, pause the video. I'll wait while you go download the guide. Okay, so in this video, I'm going to go into where ads showed, which basically tells us which channels did our YouTube ads run on, okay? This isn't going to show us the specific videos that our channel that our ads showed on. It's only going to show the channels that our ad showed on. It'd be great, YouTube, if you're watching, to give us visibility into the specific videos, but I'll take what I can get. So to get to this section, you can look at a specific ad group, a specific campaign, or all your campaigns. What I'm going to do is go into video campaigns. Because if there are discovery or display campaigns, I don't really want to see where all the display ads showed. I just want to see the YouTube channels that my ads appeared on. Within video campaigns, then, you can go to placements and then where ads showed. And I sort this either by impressions from high to low or by cost from high to low, because there are going to be a lot of channels on this list. You can see there are 87,000 channels on this list just in the last 180 days. And we're probably not going to be able to look at all of those. And if something's only getting one impression, we don't really need to look at it. Okay, I want to wait till there's at least some activity on a channel before I take the time to look too deeply into it. So sort by high to low, because what we find here is going to potentially have the biggest impact. What we first want to look for are just any obviously bad placements. Like if we're seeing children's channels, or like music video channels for the most part, gaming channels, those are usually going to bring pretty low quality traffic. And even if we don't have a lot of data yet for one of those channels, we can usually make the decision to just go ahead and turn it off just based on the content of the channel. Or if there's some channel that you know is just a really bad match for your target customer, then you can exclude those channels just based on what you know about your customer. To exclude a channel, well, let's look here. I don't see any obviously bad channels here. What I do see, though, are I do see this channel, for example, with an extremely high cost per conversion. This is definitely a channel that we would want to exclude. So to exclude a channel, you could select it here and then exclude it from the ad group or exclude it from the campaign. For a channel that's doing this poorly, I would want to exclude this channel from the whole account. To do that, up in tools and settings, you can go to placement exclusion lists. Here you can add the links to all the channels that you want to exclude. And then you can just apply that list to all of the campaign. So rather than going through and excluding one by one from each campaign, I'd recommend making a list. So this is one thing to look for. Are channels with a high cost per conversion compared to your average? And you would want to consider excluding these from not just the campaign, but from the whole account. One thing you can look at too, maybe there's a channel that's questionable, like this one, definitely higher than average. But this is only going to show this channel's performance on one campaign. what I can do is search this and see if there are any other instances of this channel. And we see quite a lot. Only a couple of them have much activity. But we can then look and see that actually on this in this campaign, this channel is performing pretty well. So I probably wouldn't want to exclude this channel from the whole account. I probably wouldn't even want to exclude it from this campaign. This looks like just a numbers game issue where sometimes when you're working with smaller numbers, results are going to be way up or way down. Given more time, the law of averages should kick in and this should start to perform better over time. Another thing to look at, so we can sort cost per conversion from high to low. This will show us a lot of the biggest culprits, a lot of the poorest performing channels. But if a channel has had zero conversions, it's not going to show up here. So another thing I want to do is look at cost from high to low and then scroll down until I come across zero conversions. Now you could set up a filter and only show channels with zero conversions, but this actually goes quicker. I already started finding some channels with zero conversions. The cost is definitely higher than we would want to pay for one or even for a couple conversions. So these should be channels that would be safe to go ahead and exclude. And lastly, so I've showed you a few ways to look for channels that you might want to exclude. You can also use this report to look for channels that you might want to target specifically. Maybe you're getting traffic to a channel through a keyword or an audience targeted campaign, and you find out here that it's a good channel. You can then take that and add it to a placement campaign. So most of these videos at the top are, or most of these channels at the top are coming up in placement campaigns. But if you're finding channels here that are bringing a lot of conversions, and you have not added these channels to a placement campaign, then I'd recommend adding them to your placement campaign. Go look at the channel, make sure it's a good fit. Make sure there's not just like one video on that channel that's driving all of these conversions. You know, sometimes a channel will be on a variety of topics. Maybe only one or two videos is really relevant to you, so it looks like that channel is performing well. When in fact, most of the videos on that channel would not perform well. So you want to look at the channel, make sure that the whole channel looks good. If not, look for the videos that seem to be bringing that traffic, the videos that are related to your customer, and just target those specific videos then in your placement campaign. So that is what I wanted to show you today. Go ahead, if you haven't done so, dig into your Where Ads Showed section. It'll tell you a lot about what's going on with your campaign, who is seeing your ad, which channels are performing good, bad, and you can adjust things accordingly. Make sure, if you haven't done so yet, to download my guide on all of this. Again, this is just one part of a 14-part series. But that guide will walk you through the whole series. So click the link with this video to download that guide now. Again, my name is Kyle Sulerud, and I will see you in the next video.